Well, the new guidelines unveiled tonight also mean we could see the Dyngus Day parade come back. Crowds of up to 200 people will be allowed in time for the event. And new at 11 tonight, Jeff Rusak shows us how this Dyngus Day could be different.
Last year, Broadway in Buffalo looked like this on Dyngus Day. Empty. The hope this year is to have it look a little bit more like this. Well, not entirely like this, but the parade organizer says right now, the plan is to have a parade on Dyngus Day.
There's really no more appropriate way than to celebrate our reawakening as a nation with some type of a procession through the historic Pelonia district.
Wednesday, the governor said by March 22nd, outdoor social gatherings of up to 200 people will be allowed. To make the parade work, the amount of people allowed in the parade would be cut in half compared to years past, and blocks would be limited to 200 spectators each.
There's plenty of room here to spread people out, and we will make sure to adhere to any mandates that are dictated to us by the government.
Erie County says they haven't received official word from the state on the new state guidelines addressed on Wednesday. They recommend anyone planning a large gathering to get in touch with their Division of Environmental Health. Dyngus Day is a month away, and while a lot can change, according to organizers, the plan right now is to have a parade.
Dyngus Day is not just a day, it's a state of mind. And that state of mind is about freedom. It's about new birth. It's about new beginning, reawakening. And that's what we're trying to demonstrate, not just for Pelonia, but for the entire region.
In Buffalo, Jeff Rusak, 7 Eyewitness News.